Welcome to American Airgunner. Today, we're traveling up north to Michigan to meet up with my buddy, Mike Pankel. Now, Mike's a great guy and a heck of a marksman, but the main reason for the visit is simple. Helium. That's right, he shoots PCPs filled with helium, and I've got to see how they work. Jim Chapman and I are going to visit some Virginia natives about different hunting techniques, and I found some really cool ammo that I just got to try out. All this coming up right now on American Airgunner. Right. Here we are in the middle of nowhere. Somewhere, we're in nowhere, Michigan right now. I'm kind of excited, don't know what to expect, but I hear air guns being shot over here. We're gonna go check out a company called Extreme Big Bore Air Rifles. Don't know what it means, I'm not really sure what they do. I can attach the word big bore to something, so I'm excited about that. Here we go. Gentlemen, what's happening? Mr. Pangle, what's up, baby?
Good to see you, man.
You too, man. How are you? I'm good.
Awesome. Rossi, Brent Hogue.
How you doing, Rossi?
It's nice. Good to finally meet you, man.
You too, buddy.
A pleasure. So just so you guys know, I met Mike Pangle at a long-distance air rifle shoot. He also shoots a gun with helium. This is why I'm here. These guys are doing amazing things with air guns that I've never even heard of. So, and from what I understand, you're the guy behind the curtain.
Yeah, I make the guns, but these guys are the ones that make them work right.
All right, so show me something. Let's get started. All right. There's a puppy. Who knew there was a puppy? Come here, puppy.
That's Fritz.
Fritz. Hey, Fritzy. What's up, bud? Oh, that's fun. I love it. All right, so this is the shop. I see a lot of helmets. That scares me.
This is the helmet of Extreme Big
Bore. So do the helmets have anything to do with air guns?
Snowmobile racing.
Okay.
Actually, when he's testing a new one, he wears a helmet.
All right, so who are these fine young people?
Bob Vogel, Mr. Hollow Point.
Oh, Bob, how are you, man? Rossi,
doing good.
Good
hey,
to finally
Rossi.
Meet you.
Excellent,
I've heard a lot about
excellent.
You through
Likewise.
Jim Chapman, and of course, the godfather of air guns has brought you up multiple times. We're talking ammunition stuff. So
excellent.
Good to finally put a face to the name. Did you just come out of the woods, or?
Yeah, pretty much. You know, when you're doing stuff, you got to dress to impress.
Sure.
So, there you go.
This is your suit.
You know, yeah. This is my suit. This is my business suit right here.
Okay. So when I met you, you were doing the helium gun thing.
Yeah.
And he built it, and then.
Yep.
And you're the helium guy. Like, you're the one that figured out how to take the helium and turn it into air and put it through the little thing and through the valve and into the.
Yes. Basically, the reason I started with the helium thing is it's one of the thinnest molecules. I started testing it for leaks.
Okay.
And then I decided, well, I'm going to shoot it one time. And I shot it, and I'm like, oh my God.
So you were using helium in your air tank because it's a smaller molecule to see if there was any leaks in the tank.
Yep.
And once it was in there, you're like, well, I've got air in there. I might as well shoot it.
Might as well shoot it.
And it was just a world of difference.
You will
see. Same exact gun.
It's unbelievable. Yes. Same gun. So basically, one of the big things with my guns is you can use air, nitrogen, or helium. And they come out of my factory like that. There's no modifications. The same gun that shoots nitrogen will be the same gun that shoots helium.
And that's not the case with all other guns?
No. A lot of people ask me about helium, if they can shoot it in other people's guns. And I tell them, you better talk to the manufacturer because you're going to get 30 to 40% more energy. It puts a lot of stress on it.
30 to 40?
Yeah. It puts a lot of stress on the frame.
Okay.
And if the frame ain't strong enough to hold it,
yeah,
you might be in trouble.
It's gonna blow up in your face.
It could. Nitrogen and helium are one of the most stable gases you can get. I believe they're an inert gas. The NASCAR guys use it in their tires.
Yeah.
Because from hot to cold, it really doesn't change.
Right.
So helium and nitrogen are your most consistent gases you can put in a rifle. Mike Pangle, he calls me up. He says, I want a rifle. And I said, Mike, here's the gun, get with Mr. Hollow Point, he'll send you the bullet, and here's the results you'll get. Yeah. And it worked out perfect.
Yeah.
What's your take on this? Did you just get a call randomly? Did you guys know each other before?
No, never heard of him. I had a 510 bullet made up, 510 diameter.
Okay.
I said, this bullet's perfect. I love this bullet, there's no gun to shoot it. So I sent him the bullet. I said, build a gun around this bullet. And he said, well, where does the bullet come from? I said, it comes from the 500 Nitro Express. So he's like, oh, no one's gonna want this, it's too big. And all of a sudden the orders started rolling in. I want a 500 Nitro Express. I want that Extreme 50 cal.
So at this point, how many different size guns do you make?
We make 257, 308, 357, I forgot that, 408, 457, 500 Nitro Express, 72 caliber 12 gauge and 20 millimeter.
Wait a minute. Air guns stop at 50.
Not here. Not here.
There you go.
What is this?
That's the 20 millimeter.
Or the 82 cal. That's 1,588 grains of hollow.
This is a joke. This is a paperweight gave you for your office.
That was a paperweight for 2 years, wasn't
it? Yeah.
He made the bullet and he's like, make me a gun. You want to see the gun?
You made this?
Yeah.
Air gun?
Air gun.
Air gun.
Yes, you heard right. We're talking about an 82 caliber air gun. Oh, keep watching.
American Air Gunner is brought to you by Umarex Air Guns, zeroed in. By Pyramid Air, the world's largest retailer of air guns, and by the Boot Campaign, awareness, patriotism, assistance.
All right, time for a quick recap because my head is still spinning. I'm in Michigan, I'm with Extreme Big Bore, and I've just been handed an 82 caliber bullet that was custom made for an air gun. I feel like I'm in the Twilight Zone. How much?
Close to 4 ounces.
What grain am I looking at here?
1588.
1500 grain. What's the range on this thing?
I don't know. That gun didn't exist until yesterday at 4 or 5 o'clock in the afternoon.
That's when I told you we were running behind.
You made this gun yesterday?
Pretty much.
So how much PSI is this thing holding?
Up to 4,500. I'm guessing that bullet will probably go 900 feet a second.
On helium, I think it's probably going to be in the eights to low eight.
This? 800 feet per second? At 822 feet per second, whatever the
bullet weighs,
mass of this, it's double that for foot-pounds.
So that would be 3,000 foot-pounds.
Do you have to shoot it with helium?
No. He shot air last night.
I was sighting it in with air yesterday.
But your tanks, your air, these hold 4,500 to 5,000 PSI?
I pressure tested them to 10,000 PSI.
This is literally the future of air. I mean, this is the future of air guns. This is what everyone's saying air guns can't get to. You're doing it.
Everybody told me it couldn't.
You're doing it in your garage.
Yeah.
Okay, guys, I got to be honest. I'm sick of talking. Let's go outside. All right, guys, I'm liking what I'm seeing here. This is fantastic.
You should feel honored.
Let go.
Mr. Hollow Point hasn't even shot this gun on helium.
What?
You're the first.
No, you are the first. 1,150 grains appear awesome.
Yeah, he is the first person to shoot that on helium, isn't he? Yep. I'm anxious to see if you stay in the chair.
I kind of feel like those atom bomb testers. Goggles on, everyone. Yeah.
Should we prop him
eyes
up
and
in
ears?
The back or what?
All right, here we go. I just got nervous.
You just got nervous. I would be too.
Did he sign the release?
I don't like y'all's nerve. Your nervous energy. You guys, you're freaking me out.
Let it rip.
All right, get out of here. Here we go.
That's going to be good, I think.
683 feet per second?
That's not good enough.
That's not good enough?
That's not good enough.
Why? What'd you expect?
Because it's only 1,100 grains.
Only 1,100 grains at almost 700 feet per second?
Well, that gun, when we get done, we'll be shooting that same bullet very close to 900 feet a second. Gotta remember, that just came out of the shop yesterday at this time. First 20 millimeter I've ever built.
Yeah, but that's still like 1,500 foot-pounds.
That's pretty good.
Guys, I gotta tell you, this has been one of the most fun afternoons of shooting air guns in the history of my life. Mr. Hollow Point, it's been a pleasure.
My pleasure, likewise.
Mr. Prangle,
yes,
it's been fun. You guys,
awesome, man.
Thanks for everything. I gotta run.
Yep.
Right, stay with us. We got more coming up on American Air Gunner. Guys, I gotta roll. Thanks for the gun. See ya!
Thanks for the gun.
Did I miss the memo?
There goes your gun, Bob.
You've been watching American Air Gunner, the only televised show all about air guns. Follow us on Facebook, Instagram, and subscribe at AmericanAirGunner.com. Now engage your brain and go shoot an air gun. What are the different ways around here in Virginia that people hunt deer?
The most common way, a lot of people just go into the woods and do their thing. I
don't know what that means.
I am, sorry about that.
We are in Virginia. Okay, can we be more specific? I don't want to go in the woods!